Hey guys, this is David Kwan here to talk a little bit about Murdered Soul Suspect. That's the name of the game, Murdered : Soul Suspect. I know, it's not a particularly great name or awesome name. Definitely is not a name that sells me on the game and makes me excited. But I think it is a name that really describes the game pretty well. It's a good name for describing what the game is. But if the marketing team wanted this game to be a really great selling game, they probably should have picked a more exciting, more awesome title. But I think it works. I'm excited for this game. It has a really interesting premise. You play as a ghost. And I really can't think of any other game, many other games, where you can play as a ghost and it's a detective game. Because you're the ghost that has to investigate the death, the murder. Your own murder, you have to investigate. Who killed you? Why? What is the killer? Who is the killer? What was he searching for? As a ghost, you're going around this world of Salem, which has a pretty amazing history of, you know, witchcraft and all that, Salem witch trials. So you're in this setting where this kind of supernatural is not all that bizarre and all that out of place. You interact with other ghosts, you help them out, and you talk with them to find out what's going on. You can possess people. But it's not like you totally possess them. You possess them to kind of get an idea of what their line of thinking is, and from that line of thinking, you can use that information to investigate more on your murder, and you can also kind of influence their thought process. So you can make them do things in the real world, which you want them to do to get deeper and deeper into the investigation. And also, once you find out the truth about your own murder, well, you have to make justice. You have to make sure that your killer gets justice. So interacting with the world as a ghost is a completely different thing than interacting with the world as an actual physical corporeal being. Concept, so awesome. I'm excited to see how this plays out and figuring out. I think it's going to be an extremely story-driven game. And the mechanics in place where you can piece together information from a crime scene, you have this scenario where you're looking at this object and you have to figure out, hypothesize what happened. And you have some options to pick, this item must have been altered recently. So you pick recently, and then this is the murder weapon. And you pick that, and you piece together, and if you get it correctly the first time, you're rewarded. If you don't, then the game just says, oh, that doesn't make sense, and you can try again. When you do, you get a flashback sequence that tells you, this is what happened. And you get to learn more information about what happened, you piece together. There is also combat involved in this game, so it's not a totally abstract game. It's not a totally new experience that's completely different. There is combat. There are demons to fight. But I think the concept of fighting these demons is pretty interesting. You can't fight them head on. It's not like you gain a weapon with the ghost and you hack it to death. No, you have to kind of still sneak behind it and come behind it and stealthily take out each demon that way. If you attack it head on, you're going to fail always. And there's going to be different types of demons and stuff. So the combat mechanics, I think, is pretty interesting. Although, at the same time, was it necessary to make this game feel gamey? I think that might be too detriment to this game. For a detective game like this, maybe they should have just focused on making a detective story-driven game instead of making it gamey. That might be a mistake. I don't know, but it is exciting. My biggest concern for this game, well, I have two concerns. One concern is the developer behind this game, Airtight Games. They don't have the strongest track record when it comes to their development history. They made Dark Void. I haven't personally played it, but that game is not considered to be a good game. And they made Quantum Conundrum, which I thought was a pretty interesting game. It was one of the main people behind that game is Kim Swift, and Kim Swift was, you know, largely responsible for Portal and Portal 2. So Quantum Conundrum was another unique game. I didn't really dig it because it lacked the vibe and the humor and the wit of Portal games, but it was still fun, but it didn't delve me into the universe. And Murdered Soul Suspect, the biggest challenge for this game is to really just engage me and just immerse me into this universe where I'm the detective. So it's one concern. The other concern, of course, is replayability. And I know this game is not going to have any replay value whatsoever. It's a story-driven linear game. So you play, you beat it, it's done. That's my prediction with this game. That doesn't worry me too much because I think if this game turns out to be a really amazing, unique experience, I'd love to own it. Just for the sake of owning this unique game and putting it on the shelf, like, yeah, I supported this developer. But if it's kind of like run-of-the-mill detective story game, then this game is going to be a rental. You know, I don't expect this game to be super long, and it doesn't have like branching path or alternate choices like a game like Heavy Rain does. So it doesn't really, I don't think it's going to invite any replay value. Maybe that's why they had to implement this gaming mechanic of avoiding demons and whatever, but I don't think people are going to replay for that. People are going to replay to enjoy the story and to enjoy this new experiences. But it's a game where once you solve the puzzle, once you solve the investigation and you figure out who killed you and why, and you do that, it's a done deal. So for most people, I have a feeling that it's going to be like a rental or something you buy and trade it in later, which would be disappointing to me because if this game turns out to be a really unique, awesome game, it's a game you should buy and should own and keep. But I don't trade in games, so that's just me. But anyway, those are my thoughts on this game. It looks really awesome. If you guys haven't heard of this game and want to know more about it, Adam Sessler did an interview with the creative designer of this game, and there's like a 27-minute gameplay coverage of that game, and the creative designer is really open. He answers the question like in a really detailed way, and I thought that was the best coverage of this game. So check this out. I think it's really something to be excited about, although I'm still kind of cautious, judging by the fact that it's being developed by Airtight Games. So yeah, thanks for watching. Cheers.